his valuable knowledge and experience for this year. Ketana Vasudev, as you all know, has got an incredible experience in the field of Indian capital markets, and he's a stalwart in the field of technical analysis. Of course, he's not a new face at all. He's a well-known personality. We have been seeing him on all the channels for years together. But at the same time, I would also like to thank acknowledge the efforts taken by our president Sushil Kedia, because of him all these ATMA meetings are happening on a one-to-one basis, and we are able to get knowledge from various experts and gurus in the field of technical analysis. As you know, this meeting will go on till about 4 o'clock. And then we will have our break and we will have our interactions and we will be to introduce you to Mr. Hitendra Vasudev. He is actually a postgraduate in economics. He is a technical analyst following all the three markets, equity, bonds, commodities and forex. He is an advisor as well as a trainer. He has trained a lot of traders and management students. He has an honor to his credit that he has developed the entire technical team at commoditycontrol.com, and has also been part of the Power Your Trade, providing technical views to a lot of stocks and commodities. He has also developed some trading systems and plugins for MetaStock, and he has about 7 years association with Falcon Brokerage for developing some technical concept based on William O'Neill concepts. Today he is here to train us, or rather show us his methods based on RSI and how he uses RSI in conjunction with various other leading and lagging indicators. He has various kinds of trade setups, that's what he mentions. I think those trade setups will probably help us and benefit us. What I would like to add is, along with the trade setup, he could also show us some good entry techniques in those trade setups and the proper stop loss and proper trade management rules in those trade setups. It would be of great help to us. Once again, welcome Hitendra, and hand over the mic to him so that he can carry things forward. Please give him a...
Good afternoon, friends. First of all, I should thank Mr. Sushil Kedia for taking this effort, because such kind of associations were tried earlier in 1999, then in 2003. But on all the occasions, it failed to take off after a few meetings like this. We should congratulate him for getting some tie-ups with MTA, which is something very good enough from the Indian investors and those who intend to use technical analysis as their subject to trade and invest. Because this is something a big leap, because getting a tie-up with MTA is not a small thing at all. So this is one should congratulate Sushil for his effort, because otherwise this association will not actually go further. Obviously he has a lot of things to do further, and the way he has spread all over the country by forming in the different pockets different leading members, whether it's West Zone, South Zone, East Zone and North Zone. So that is something which is good enough to take control of technical analysis as a subject, because it's a stepmotherly treatment to technical analysis when it's compared to fundamentals. So we all know that if a fundamental guy is getting 1 lakh, technical analysis will get 15,000-20,000 or at the most 40,000, depending on his experience. So that is not justifiable, because technical analysis as a subject in itself is an ocean, because it can bring you bigger pictures of 100 years and 150 years. Probably the other mode of analysis may not actually permit you to give such kind of larger pictures, because ultimately all not to degrade any kind of mode of analysis, but most of the work which is being done is not investigative, it is cut-paste work. So very few people are doing investigative work in the respective field of fundamental analysis, and probably they are the leading operators or either they are big fund managers if they have done some kind of investigative work. So coming back to our field, technical analysis is something which is like a passion to probably to everyone who is sitting around, and they believe that it is the ultimate way to do analysis, because as we know, the basic thing is price discounts everything. So we obviously think that everything is taken care of, whether it is a natural calamity or even act of God, as we say, is being catered in the price. So price is a leading indicator to your known and unknown fundamentals. So price is something all that is required for us. So the concept which I am going to talk is everybody is familiar and very simple, and everybody is using it already. So maybe I might be able to throw some lights or give you a thinking points further, so that you can explore your ways and your own techniques to trade and invest into the market. So a lot of things are aware to you, but I will still go through the motions of initial part before actually finally going to the setup part. So it is very important that we should talk about not the theory, what is RSI, but what are the concepts required, because no technique in this world on a standalone basis would provide best results. So it always has to be in some conjunction with some other technique to time your trade. Plus, any technique probably might give you a good entry but may not give you a good exit, and vice versa. So therefore the combination of a couple of techniques enables you to remove the limitation of one technique, say called RSI. Probably it will have certain limitations, and other techniques will take over that limitation and provide you a good sense of trade or good sense of argument to buy or sell. So we will be looking at some other concepts simultaneously along with it. So how we can base your decisions. Why I'm picking up RSI is purely because it will tell you it when, say for example, it is above 70 or above, according to me, it is above 70 or above 30, which is your decision making points, not in between. So there are techniques like, okay, RSI going above 50, then you know it's an establishment of an uptrend on the RSI front. That example also we'll see. But your decision to buy or sell, whatever it is, it's either above RSI 70 or other below RSI 30. So either you can see when it's going above RSI 70, acceleration of momentum in the direction of the price. Without RSI coming under 70, you might see stocks doubling and tripling.